you have a house lights button back here? No, for what Christy just explained to me is I have access to the square lights up behind there. So I'll turn them off. But then there's little round lights that are called house lights. So do you have that button? Looks like some of them are off. Do you see them though? Do you see the round lights? Kind of on the crosses on the ceiling.
Get somebody.
Yeah, there's a girl in there for nails.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
I was worried that it wasn't going to work out, and I thought, gosh, maybe I should bring my camera. Because I didn't want you guys to open and not have it, and then I...
Hi,
Sid
Grayson. Hi, sit back there. Hi, Miss Maya. Listen, Grayson, can I sit back there? This
third grade production of Heroes All. We'd like to begin our performance with the singing of the national anthem by Mrs. John Acopta. Please rise. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the third grade production of Heroes All. Now that we ask you to be a very respectful audience and stay seated until the end of the musical production.
Without further ado, we now present to you Heroes All.
So many people lived and dreamed to run on the street that we call America.
From founding fathers, from all lands, from great inventors to great writers, from artists to athletes, we always have heroes to pave our way.
These are my heroes. This is their song. Graduate in honor. Their pride is strong. They can run. They can fly. They can teach. They can.
difficult, but the very effort to gain it creates character. Only through perseverance and overcoming obstacles can you accomplish anything worthwhile.
We think little of what we win easily.
It is struggle that gives victory its preciousness.
The world is full of heroes, those living and those who have gone before us to pave our way.
Each of them has somehow managed to accomplish some remarkable feat.
They have done it with courage, dignity, and honor.
What does it take to be a hero?
Will I have a chance someday?
Thank you, American heroes, for showing us the way.
It's 1936, the Olympic Games. Place, Berlin, Germany.
Under the condescending gaze of Adolf Hitler, a young African-American places his feet in the starting blocks of the 200-meter race.
Hitler never thought this man could beat his German runners.
Even many Americans had their doubts.
Over the course of the next few days, that young Olympian would not only win, but set the world record in the 200-meter race and the long jump.
He would tie the world record in a 100-meter dash and win even a fourth gold medal as a 400-meter relay team.
In doing so, he would simply shatter records, but begin to tear down the walls of hate and prejudice that infested our country and much of the world.
Through his heroic example, young people like me are shown new possibilities for our lives.
People like me were taught that no dream is too big and no goal is unattainable.
He was an American hero, and his name was
Jesse Owens.
There was a time when racism could never be won.
Lily Blythe, what in the world has gone into you?
I must tell you that I think I can make it around the world in less than 80 days. And if you weren't so pig-headed, you'd be encouraging me to do just that.
Now hold on there, Nellie. When you wanted to write that article on tough conditions for a working woman, who was it that gave you this support?
You did, sir, but...
And when you went undercover at the hospital and exposed to horrible conditions there, who let you do it even though it was ready on becoming of a woman?
You did, sir. It was the best article of its kind by a man or a woman. You said so yourself.
True, but now you want to travel around the world by who knows what means. Just prove that a woman can do it.
Exactly. Thank you for your understanding, boss, and for your wonderful support. I leave immediately.
Nellie, not so fast now. You come back here. Nellie, I never said Nellie.
Thank you. mess in there. I spent weeks cleaning up after the last experiment on the effects of the sun and rotten eggs.
Yes, Mother. Rats, I know I'm close on this formula for theory of relativity. I just need some time to think.
Albert!
Think, I've gotta think.
Thank you. Helen Keller, born in 1880, was destined to become one of the most inspirational persons the world has ever known.
Helen Keller, American hero.
When she was only 19 months old, she became sick and lost her ability to hear and see.
No one knew how to teach her.
Helen Keller, American hero.
Because she was blind and deaf, she couldn't communicate with the world.
And then Annie Sullivan, an amazing teacher, came into her life.
At the age of 10, she learned to speak in less than a month. 10 years later, in 1904, she attended Radcliffe College and graduated with honors.
Helen Keller, American hero.
Throughout her life, Helen Keller gave lectures all around the world to support the causes of blind and deaf people.
She taught everyone with whom she came in contact that true vision is not seeing only with your eyes.
True listening is not only about hearing through your ears.
True listening, true vision, true nobility come from within.
Helen Keller, American hero.
I see. household. He flew solo, nonstop from New York to Paris in 33 and a half hours.
Charles Lindbergh, how does it feel to be the first one ever to accomplish such a daring feat?
It feels great.
Sir, you might not think that I might not make it over that continent.
Some people are calling it the greatest fire of all time. What do you think about that?
Tort nothing. Oh, and folks, by the way, it feels great.
Charles Lindbergh, now that you've completed this historic flight to everyone else, can you tell us what it takes to be a real hero?
Folks, the potential to bring our heroes inside each and every one of us. All you have to do is have the courage to dream and the willingness to seize the opportunity when it presents itself.
Mr. Lindbergh, you mean I could be a hero like you someday?
Look to the skies, young lady. Dream big. There's a hero inside you just waiting to fly free.
Wow.
So how does it feel, kid? How does it feel to dream of being a hero?
It feels great.
In Mercury capsule friendships, In April 1959, Mercury capsule Friendship 7 sent me on a mission to orbit the Earth. John Glenn!
My team and I was the first to land on the moon July 20th, 1969. One small step for man, one great leap for mankind. Neil Armstrong.
Sally Ride, I was a mission specialist and first woman to travel to space.
Ellen Ochoa, I was the first Hispanic female astronaut.
Astronauts!
Bethany Hamilton, I've helped more people with one arm than I ever could with two.
I show that during a violent time is the best way to change the countries to peace and love. Martin Luther King Jr.
They said I wasn't a good enough freshman in high school, but that didn't stop me from playing basketball. Now I'm known as Air Jordan, Michael Jordan.
I was the first woman to become the United States Secretary of State, Madeleine Albright.
I, Sandra Day O'Connor, was the first woman on Supreme Court.
Jackie Robinson, I broke my baseball color line and was the first black man to play in the major leagues since the 1880s.
Henry Ford played a Ford Motor Company.
Signed, seal, and delivers. Stevie Wonder.
The treehouse started to spin. It spun faster and faster. Then everything was still, absolutely still. Reading can take you on the greatest adventures. Mary Pope Osborne.
Will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. Dr. Seuss.
M-I-C-K-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Mickey Mouse.
Donald Duck!
Welcome to the wonderful world of Walt Disney.
I am a doctor who helps get rid of coronavirus that harm many. Johnny Stock.
I was born with a club foot, but still became the youngest American woman to win a World Cup championship. Mia Hamm.
I was the 1984 all-around gold medalist in gymnastics. Mary Lou.
Anna Jarvis, I am the mother of Mother's Day.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. There's no business like your business. God bless America, land that I love. I'm Irving Berlin, one of the greatest songwriters in American history.
It is our pleasure to introduce our very own community heroes.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We would like to take this opportunity to recognize our community heroes. We are honored to have them in our presence this morning. When I announce your name, we would like you to please stand and come up front to be recognized. Sergeant Major Joshua Paulus, Oregon National Guard, 2nd 162nd Infantry. Dr. T. Douglas Blaze, MD, Family Health Associates. Mr. Wade Smith, Deputy Superintendent. Mrs. Bryn Browning, Assistant Superintendent. Oh, yes. Brianna Porter Barrera, District Office. Ms. Karen Sherman, retired educator, chairman of the Hermiston School Board. Ms. Ginny Holtis, accountant, school board member, and Hermiston Woman of the Year. Ms. Diane Sheik, nutrition specialist. Ms. Crystal Schmidt, collegiate athlete, BMCC volleyball player, first team All Northwest Athletic Association of Community Colleges. Ms. Danielle McBride, Hermiston High School girls soccer coach, conference coach of the year. Billy Joe Burns, Blue Mountain Community College health instructor. Megan Baskins, Paige Baskins, and CJ Areola, three kids curing cancer. Officer Gretchen, Distinguished Citizens Award for Firefighter of the Year, Fire Prevention and Safety for Hermiston School. Ms. Christy Smalley, Coach for Special Olympics. Officer Shane Robinson, Patrol Officer. Mr. Dave Smith, business owner in Hermiston Community. Ladies and gentlemen, please give one more round to our community heroes.
for coming. We hope you enjoy the show and learning more of the history of this great country.
Please meet your podiums and pay special attention to all of those involved that make this program a success.
A special thanks to Hermiston Education Foundation, our community heroes, Mrs. Ronenberg, our third grade teachers, Mr. Rodarte, Mrs. Copta, Mr. Wilson, volunteer support, Mrs. Ronenberg, and our third grade teachers.
Performance this evening beginning at 6 o'clock. 6:30 this evening. We would love if you would come share in our performance one more time this evening. Thank you.